You know, they had this expression out in the West that, you know, whiskey is for drinking, water for fighting. Around here, with so much fresh water, is that not so?
The fighting here is usually over the cost of water and what people are paying for water, because it's very abundant. We're in the Great Lakes State. 20% of the surface fresh water on the planet is here. We're literally sitting in the middle of a crown jewel, which is water.
This is the Saudi Arabia of water?
I would say so. Basically, there's limited supplies of water on the planet. You have to have it to survive. The planet's population is growing. Urban areas are growing. They need water. And it's going to be more abundant and available here if we manage it properly.
It is an out of sight, out of mind issue, isn't it?
Absolutely. And unless sewer collapses or you hear about a break in a pipe. And one of the ironies is that the utilities have done a pretty good job under tough circumstances of managing the systems. So the system's working, it's available. They don't see what's under the ground, that it's deteriorating. So it's a little harder to get people interested in saying, we're investing in this because it's our future. When you get home tonight, look out your front door, see how far it is from your house to your street. Now remember, there's a pipe under the ground going there. Now look down your street and count the houses. They all have a pipe going to the street. Now look down your street and make an estimate of where the closest big road is, and everything from everybody's house is going through some pipe to that big road, then it's going down that big road to another big road. Now, add up all that distance. Sure. So what Detroit Water and Sewage Department is managing and talking about is what they have. What we have in our own communities is just as important. You know, that lead from your house to the street, down the street, all of that is infrastructure we have to take care of.
Do you have the sense that we really don't know the level of the problem that exists beneath the streets?
It's not a sense, it's the truth. This is not Detroit, this is basically a pervasive problem around the country. What's staggering is if you look at what other parts of the world that we compete with are doing, you'll see that they're investing massive amounts of money. What we have is a mismatch between that new value of I want it better and what can we actually do. You know, can we make a system that was started to be built 100 years ago do the tricks that we want out of this current value system? And in some cases the answer is yes. In some cases, the answer is not really, and in all cases, it's expensive.
Champagne taste on a beer budget.
could be.
How much of the whole picture here is the amount we use? If we used less, would there be less of a problem or not?
The answer is yes, there would be less of a problem. And in our case, we have a large supply of water. In some parts of the country and most parts of the planet don't have anywhere near the supply of water we have. So people say, well, why do we have to use less? Because if we use less, we'll have to pay less for the infrastructure that takes care of it. So the supply of the product is in abundance. But remember, we have to pull it out of a river and a lake and deliver it, pump it uphill several miles, in some cases 30, 40, 50 miles, to get it to somebody's doorstep under any conditions. So if we find ways of using less, then we won't have to have as much infrastructure in place to get it there, and that will save us money. We tend to think of it as like a tax or just a charge. We're actually buying a product, and we're investing in our future. If you're buying the water, you're buying a product at a fraction of the cost of what, you know, a penny a gallon.
The other factor that is perhaps more of an, well, no, it is more of an issue here than most places, is the shrinking nature of the city and the declining economic base. How much can Detroit afford at this point when it comes to meeting the federal guidelines and keeping the thing from collapsing?
Well, we're in the proverbial catch-22, right? If we don't take care of the system, then the condition of infrastructure deteriorates more and it's a less desirable place to live and more people want to leave. If we try to take care of it too fast and do too much, we're going to raise the cost to the point where people can't afford to live there.
It's a tough needle to thread.
It's a very tough needle to thread, and this is as much art as it is science, trying to figure these things out. I'm a big believer in incremental progress. Again, don't let the perfect be the enemy of the good. And that's where we're going to make progress, getting alignment between the different things that we're trying to do.
It's tough shit.
It's tough.
Sorry.